Hello everyone. I'm doing a review today on this refrigerator. It's a Samsung RF27T5501SG. It is a side-by-side with a freezer on the bottom. So the reason why it still has all the stickers on it is because my wife and I have not put it in the house yet, so we did not want to take any of that stuff off of this particular one until we moved it in the house so it didn't scratch or anything. But that's why it has all the packaging on it still. As soon as we get it inside, that'll move off. But I do have a picture of how it comes. It comes completely wrapped with foam and absolutely protected. The handles aren't on, they're inside. You gotta put them on. It's pretty nice though, the way it's sent. It's very protected. This is the black aluminum, which is really, really nice. Try to get a close up of it. That is the black aluminum right there. And then this, of course, is the protective material. Start with the outside. The handles are aluminum. They're very nice. I'll discuss how they work a little bit later on. And then the water dispenser is the same as most of their Samsung water dispensers. We did recently have another Samsung refrigerator almost identical to this one, except for it was French doors all the way down, freezer on one side, fridge on the other. And the water dispenser was the same. So I would say one of the concerns I had that I'll clarify is there's no tray inside of these Samsung fridges, most of them anyway. And it seems almost as if it's missing, and it's weird. However, having owned that other fridge, I would tell you that this is fine. I thought initially I was a little concerned with it. I almost didn't get the fridge because of that, not having that tray in there. But after using the fridge for about 6 months, we noticed that the water catches in here just fine. And then, of course, ice is going to bounce off the tray anyway. So this does what it's supposed to do. It's got this little indentation in here that catches the majority of the water should it flow over. But really, the dispenser is really good, and not much water spills over except for when the kids overfill their cups. So that wasn't an issue. I know a lot of comments on websites are about them not having a tray in here. I didn't see a need for it. It worked out just fine for us. So one thing I want to mention is this water dispenser does not have an LED light. That is a little frustrating, because as much money as you pay for this, you'd think you'd have that. And here's why it's frustrating. This screen is very bright at night. So when you come into the kitchen, it has motion sensors right here, which ideally is good, because when you walk by it, it turns it on. You don't have to mess with anything. But the bad thing is it blinds this out. It washes it out. So when you walk in the kitchen, it flashes on. If you want to get your water or something like that, and you don't want to turn on the lights, you're not going to really be able to see this. And I'm not joking. Like it washes it out completely. And I'm kind of feeling around trying to guess where it's at, and then I finally get it. I usually come in real close just to see in my own cubes. For a refrigerator this expensive, I would hope that they would put like an LCD or something in here, so when you come by them and they got motion sensors on this, just put a motion sensor here so the light comes on. That'd be a nice addition, but it doesn't have that, so we just turn the motion sensors off. And I'm sure you can go in there and set it up for times and stuff like that. It's I haven't gotten in that far yet, but if you like want to turn it on after 08 in the morning, then you could do that. But we just turn the motion sensors off so that at night when you come in, you can actually see the water dispenser well enough to get your water or ice without turning on the lights. Here you have three very nice shelves. They do come off, so you can adjust them to different locations. That's very nice. And then inside of here, you've got the nice glass shelves, big nice metal reinforcement. And what I like about this particular fridge is, and that was one of the shelves that just came off really easily, is the wheels. So each of these drawers have wheels in them, and they roll extremely nice. And they lock out. When it come out, it drops into a lock position, and then you can slide it back in just like that. So way to go, Samsung. Very nice. And shelf just drops right back in, no problem. The other thing I'll notice about these shelves is they're very sturdy. So I've got the milk in here moving around. The shelf doesn't wiggle at all. You know how sometimes the shelves will move around a little bit? Nope, not these things. Very solid in place. Another thing we like about this refrigerator is a lot of the Samsung refrigerators don't have drawers because of the cameras. Look at the entire inside of the refrigerator. However, this one has, they all have two drawers, but this one has a nice cheese drawer at the bottom. So that's a nice thing to have. You don't know that you'll miss it until you have a fridge that doesn't have one. And our last Samsung didn't have one because it had the camera that was looking at all the shelves, and they didn't want to interfere with what was in the shelves, I guess. So that's a really nice thing to have, which is one of the reasons why we like this fridge better. Another thing I'll highlight about this fridge as opposed to the other ones, I'll go ahead and show that. This one right here has It's called All Around Cool, and you don't realize that you'll notice it until you do. It's absolutely fascinating how something can be sitting over here and be just as cold as something down here. And like I said, you wouldn't normally notice that because most fridges, you just grab something and it's cool, right? Until you do, until I notice that everything is the same temperature. Of course, if you put something right up here against the vent, it'll get a little cold. But for the most part, the entire refrigerator is cool all around. And I thought like it was a gimmick type thing. And I guess it's got vents everywhere. Nope, it actually works. So it's very good. First that I do like is that it has humidity controls in both drawers. So that's awesome. Most fridges only have it in one drawer and the other one's just kind of a drawer. Well, now I can have two drawers that I set the humidity on each of them so I can make sure that the whatever ingredients or whatever stuff I have in that drawer, whatever food I have in that drawer, the humidity is set for that particular food. I really like that because I do like to have my food in areas where it's supposed to be, like my onions, so they don't, you know, make other stuff go bad. But one thing I wanted to highlight about these doors is some fridges, they're very hard to open. After you close the door, the pressure from the door closing keeps it stuck to the fridge for a little while, but not these. So I'm going to open it with one finger. Go ahead and close it and open it with one finger again. Very, very easy. Same thing with the other side. The other side's got the panel that comes out and it just closes, no problem. So same thing, nice and easy to open, nice and easy to close. So I'd like to talk about the freezer. This handle right here pulls up, and when I talked earlier about wanting to talk about the handles, this one actually comes up and it jars the freezer, so it breaks that pressure we were talking about earlier. Really nice because it's just natural. You do it, it opens up, makes it really, really easy to open up. And then inside of the freezer, you've got the top tray, which slows back. Same thing, it's got wheels on the side. When you pull it out, it locks into place, and then you can push it back and then close it. When you open it up, try to get back up to the front again, which is really nice. Now, you have to look at specifications to see how big this is. I don't remember off the top of my head, but what I will say is that we had a 14 cubic foot deep freezer, and we had that thing full, well, not full, it was halfway full, so about 7 cubic foot. So I'd say it's got about 7 cubic foot worth of stuff in here right now, and I still got plenty of room. So very nice freezer, easy to close, very smooth to roll in the house.
No issues with
handprints. You know, they get handprints all over them. We got little kids that get handprints all over it. Easy to wipe off. You know, easy to wipe off. Usually our fridge is covered with stuff anyway. Now, you know, we can't necessarily do that because you got the screen here and all of our pictures, which is also cool. All of our pictures are on the screen. They're no longer magneted to the fridge, and our planner is also on the screen. So you can tie in. We just, you know, you tell your little home assistant what you want, things to do list, and later on it's right here. So all of our planning, all of our meal planning, everything is we're now transferring to this hub, which is nice because you can do that through your phones, your iPhones, because they have the Samsung app and it is all transferable into here. So that's really good. But there's actually two fridges here, and that's because we have the one Samsung and now this additional. Got a very large family, gotta have lots of fridges. So I'll show you this one. You just hit the refrigerator, and then I'll show you what the cameras look like. This is what the dashboard looks like. It's got the temperature of the fridge, temperature of the freezer. You can do power cool, power freeze. You can turn the ice maker off. Right now it's off because it's not plugged in. The ice maker water is not plugged in. And then you can look at the inside of the fridge. Now this is what I like about this one. So you can see all three shelves. There's the bottom shelf. There's the middle shelf. There's the top shelf. Or you click on it, and it shows you all three shelves, all three of them. Now, I'll show you the other fridge, which is a Samsung fridge, which has one camera just to get a different perspective. If you're looking at these fridges, whether you want one camera or two or three cameras, that's what the one camera, or here, I'll turn it back. That's what the one fridge camera looks like. Now, it's got all three shelves. There's one shelf, two shelves, and three shelves, and there's one shelf above that. The camera does not move around. It does the best that it can to try and get a good picture of everything, but there's only one camera, so that's what it looks like. So when you're looking at buying one of these fridges, this particular one has three cameras, and now you know the difference. So if you're wondering, well, do I want one camera or do I want three cameras? Well, I would say if you're going to get a camera, then just get the three, because look, it's, I don't cost more, but it is definitely better. And it's not all distorted because it's trying to get that really wide angle lens to look at everything. So that's that. One other thing I'll show you is, in case you didn't know, these fridges have speakers. Now, I'm going to play it here in a second, but if you look, it tells you, you know, it says things like the refrigerator door on the inside of the house has been open 45 times, and the refrigerator on the outside, this one's been open 10 times. And it tells you stuff like that. The only thing I do not like about the Samsung networks, or the Samsung family hub, they call it, is it's Samsung specific. So why that matters is because, let's say, I was really excited when we first got this because my wife likes to watch videos and stuff on her iPad in the kitchen, and this will play YouTube videos, but what it doesn't do is it won't play Netflix because the player inside of the family hub does not have the right software to communicate with the Netflix videos or any Amazon videos or any of that stuff. So you can play YouTube, but if you want to play a movie, what you have to do is you have to, like, if you want to watch Netflix, you have to mirror your Samsung device on here, which it will do. So if you have a Samsung Galaxy or a Samsung, the phone or the tablet, you can mirror it on here, and anything you do on your tablet, you can just do right on here, and it works, no problem. We don't do that. We have Apple, so unfortunately, everything that we have does not interact with this. I am hoping that at some point, I mean, Samsung's been running these things for a while now, but I'm hoping at some point Samsung will allow this to interface with other devices. Samsung, if you're listening, make it universal. That'd be awesome. But here's one thing I wanted to do, get a little lost sometimes on this thing, is I'll play some music. So I know you can't really tell what it sounds like through the camera, but I do want to play it just so you get a general idea. If you didn't know, there are speakers in this fridge. Now, my speakers still have the cover on them because I don't want to mess with it, but I'm gonna go ahead and play some. Okay, so now I'm walking away from it. So in the kitchen, that is really nice. And when you play your YouTube, because YouTube will pull up, and when you play your YouTube stuff on here, let's not do that video. We'll do this one. You know, it'll play your YouTube videos on there. So if you're looking at, like,
imagine a world where cars can walk upstairs, wade through rivers, and
so, you know, cars can already wade through rivers. Just in case you were wondering. But that's it. If you got any questions, please feel free to ask. Put them down in the comments. I try to answer questions as fast as I can. If you want to see anything else, let me know, and I'll try to take pictures of it and put it on there. I will admit I'm not as good at YouTube as I'd like to be, so it may take me a while to get posts and stuff on there, because I'm not quite sure how to do that yet, but I'm learning. And just ask me anything you got, and I'll do that for you. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the review on the fridge.